Hey everybody.
Hi Dave.
Our response is proud. I love it.
All right.
On behalf of the entire BMW product communications team, I want to thank you from my side also for coming tonight. I get the best part of this gig because I get to talk about the cars. Before I do also want to make a couple of program notes and also make some introductions. I want to make sure that everybody's aware of the fact that unfortunately because of scheduling conflicts, both Oliver and Howard will not be with us tomorrow. So now's your chance. If you got questions, you gotta get on. But they're more than happy to answer any questions you have if they have answers, and if they don't, well, they'll make something up, but I promise it sounds really good. And of course, as you know, these kinds of programs never come together without a lot of hard work from a lot of people. And for us here at BMW North America, this program, the man behind the curtain, our group communications manager, Michael McHale, pulling the strings and levers. Our BMW product communication specialist, Bill Scully, will be with us and available for answering questions if you have them throughout the program. Man who's guaranteed popularity by the simple fact that he's the guy with the car, keys to the cars. Our press fleet manager, Vinny Cohn. And last, but by no means least, the person who makes sure that these programs look as elegant as this room looks, my colleague, Laura Pumps. Now, it's my job to impart upon you all kinds of information about these cars. You will have received two press kits in your room. They will cover both the entire Z4M product line, both models, as well as the M5 and M6. And I thought, to make sure that we covered all the information and didn't leave anything out, that I should just basically read through the press kit line by line. Kidding! But here we go. As Oliver alluded to, the great thing about where we start out with M cars is they start with the basic BMW products and work to make them better. In the case of the M6, the exciting thing about this car is it, on some levels already, is pushing the envelope in terms of technology to a very high degree. One of the areas where the 6 Series really pushes the envelope, besides the fact that it's drop-dead gorgeous, is in our lightweight technology. A 6 Series, the 650, already has thermoplastic front fenders. It already has sheet molded compound rear deck lid. It already has aluminum doors. It already has an aluminum hood as well as an aluminum suspension system to make the car as light as possible. And of course, in the M6, we take it a step further by adding, as I've already mentioned, the carbon fiber roof. It does two important things for us. I mean, it not only gets us to this point here about the lowest power drag ratio in its class, about 7 pounds per horsepower, but with BMW in general, and this is particularly true for the folks at M, is they're not only looking for weight savings, but they're always looking for the double dividend. One benefit's never enough. They always want the extra benefit. And with things like the carbon fiber roof, not only is it making the car light overall, but it's also reducing the center of gravity, which pays an extra dividend in terms of dynamics. Just as with our cars, when we build so much of the suspension of aluminum in the front structure of the 6 Series, balances the car better, but also, because we're reducing unsprung weight, it helps the dynamics of the car. Also true for all of the cars you'll be driving tomorrow, you can see it right here when looking at the car, the compound cross-drill brake rotors not only pay dividends, they're vented, the cross-drill for extra, for lighter weight, better venting, but because they have aluminum center hubs, those parts of the suspension also are lighter. Lower weight overall, but also helps the dynamics of the car, which is really important for us from that perspective. Oliver went through talking about a lot of the sophistication of these cars, and well, I could cover that ground again. And believe me, I want to. I really do. But I won't. But some points here to be made. He talked about the DSC. It says here 2-stage DSC, but that's something of a misnomer because it's actually a 3-stage DSC in the M6, because in truth, you have the standard DSC mode. If you try it in regular DSC mode, you'll find that even that the guys at M can't leave alone, because it's designed in such a way that it'll let you get the tail loose a little. But if that's not enough for you, there is the M dynamic mode in DSC, which takes that threshold up further to allow a little more slide before things start to happen electronically. But of course, because it's BMW and because it's BMW M, there's always the option to turn the system off completely, and then you're on your own. In the case of the M6, they also have an electronic damping control, a 3-stage electronic damping control system that you'll be able to experience tomorrow. helps to balance ride quality with responsiveness. And as you'll see here, these guys are not capable of compromising on much of anything in these cars, as you'll see. The engine, of course, we already talked about, a V10, high revving, 500 horsepower, made to a 7-speed sequential manual gearbox. And this new gearbox is faster for two main reasons. One of which is, of course, designed as a 7-speed, designed as an SMG. It was designed in such a way that they weren't held to having to have a regular gated shifter. And so it's configured in a very different way. With very sophisticated electronics, those two things combined together make this a very, very fast shifting program. In our M6, 0-60 in 4.5 seconds. But as you see tomorrow, all the luxury amenities, everything you could possibly want, all the space, and that's the other great thing about the folks at BMW M. And many of you, most of you, experienced it today. Who at BMW M could design and build a five-liter V10, 500 horsepower, 4.5 second, 0-60, four-door, five-passenger airport limo? And that's what makes the car so special. And now we're seeing it being expanded, as Oliver said, into the Z4 line. Now you can just imagine the conversation went on back at Garkin with the folks at BMW M. Hey, I got an idea. What if we lifted the engine and drivetrain suspension system out of the M3, and we added to it the braking system out of an M3 CSL, and jammed them into a Z4 Roadster? I don't know, it works for me. Now, having done that, as many of you have already experienced having driven that car, and you get another chance to drive it tomorrow, you might then say, well, you got that car, Z4, M Roadster, like it, it's great, it's fun. But if that car is already so good, why do you need a coupe? Look at it! And the great thing about this design is that it translates so well from Roadster to coupe. And I haven't heard a single reference to footwear with this version. The other advantage, of course, is for those who prefer a closed car, as some do, it gives you this advantage, but also, of course, again, double dividend. It's a closed car, which means that the chassis is inherently stiffer, which has benefits in terms of responsiveness and handling. You have to experience that tomorrow. It's the familiar M3 engine, 0-60, 4.9 inches, 6-speed manual transmission. It does have the M differential lock, as all M cars these days do, which makes a huge difference in the way this car, any M car, is able to put power to the ground by managing wheel slip from side to side. Hydraulic power steering, as it says there, the M3 CSL cross-drilled compound brakes. It's just an amazing package. And, as we saw and heard on the Today Show back about a month ago, it legitimately will hold two golf bags in the back. So there's also that practicality element to it. So there's all M cars. I mean, these just aren't cars made to go fast. These are cars that are made that you can use every day inside yourself. Now, in addition, this car benefits from all of our latest technology in terms of safety technology, but also in terms of things like the dynamic stability control system. Specially designed by M, again, to keep life entertaining. You can't switch the system off, but also it takes advantage of some of our latest technology, like brake drawing, for example, which sadly the last group that was here really got familiar with. But also, and this is something you should try tomorrow when you can, because there's a lot of, as you'll see on the route tomorrow, there's lots of up and down transitions. It also has the start-off assistant. So you'll be able to see in these cars that feature will hold for about 3 seconds on an uphill grade before it lets go, so you don't have to do the shuffle with all three pedals. So you want to give that a try. Now, Oliver talked about all the settings that you can do on the M6, and just as a quick program note for tomorrow, yes, there are, as you've seen in the literature, and it's really true when you start to add it up. Believe me, we've done the math. There are 279 program changes that you can make on the M6 or M5. The engine, the 7-speed sequential manual gearbox, the steering, the DSC, the EDC, all those things. You can change them around. Now, what Vinny and his guys have done is they program the M button on the steering wheel. When you push that, you'll actually get the 500 sport mode, because a lot of people don't understand it. It's not just a choice of 400 to 500 horsepower. There's also a separate 500 sport program you can get to by diving into the iDrive. See, it's paying dividends. iDrive, it's in there. And what that does is it changes the throttle responsiveness to what happens with your foot. It opens the throttles that much faster. So what these guys have done, these guys, they programmed it for 500 sport. Correct me if I get this wrong, I think I got it. 500 sport, the fastest shift speed for the SMG, the M dynamic mode for the DSC, and they put it in the normal mode. There are three stages to the EDC. There's comfort, normal, and sport. They actually put it in the normal mode because what you'll find tomorrow is that will give you a nice ride on regular road, but when it needs to firm up in the corners, it'll do it. So you can check that out. So that's what we'll get there. Now what I'll recommend to you guys is drive it without, when you first leave the hotel tomorrow, or when you first leave lunch in the M6, if that's your first turn in the car, drive it with everything off. Don't mess around with the buttons just yet. Just drive the car, get a feel for it, and then hit that M button and see what a difference that makes. And the character of the car will change completely. It's amazing. On the subject of tomorrow and driving, just want to let you know that breakfast tomorrow will be available beginning at 8 o'clock. Our driver's briefing will start at 9:20, so there's no rush.